Welcome to the Angular Button tutorial. The Syncfusion Angular Button component is a graphical user interface element that triggers an event on click action. It contains the text, an icon, or both. In this video, I will show you how to create an Angular app and add the Syncfusion Angular Button component to it. You will also see some of its basic features like button styles and types, adding icons and displaying them in different positions, and adding custom styles to the button. I will start with the application creation process. I'm going to create an Angular application using the Angular CLI tool. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Node.js. First, open Visual Studio Code and install the Angular CLI using the npm install -g at angular/cli command. As I have already installed it, I am skipping this step here. Next, I will create a new Angular project using the ng new project name command and name my project example. This will create an Angular project along with its dependencies. Now, let me navigate to the project folder to add the Syncfusion Angular Button component. Install the Syncfusion Angular Buttons package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2angularbuttons --save command. This will install the package with its dependencies. The application is now ready to use. Before using the Syncfusion component, I need to register the trial license key. I open the main.ts file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate this license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use the Syncfusion components. First, I navigate to the app component.ts file and import the button module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Buttons package. Then, register it within the imports array of the component section. Next, to reference the CSS styles to the button, navigate to the style.css file and import the material theme. In the app component HTML file, remove its default content and add the button tag with the EJ's button attribute. And set the button content as play. I save the changes and run the application using the ng serve command. See, the button is rendered with the defined content. Next, I will show you how to apply built-in styles to the button component. The available styles are primary, success, informative, warning, danger, and link. From these, I choose to apply the primary style. I add the CSS class property and assign the primary class to it. See here, the primary style is applied to the button. Next, let me show you the different types of buttons. The Syncfusion Angular button can be displayed in different types like flat, outline, round, and toggle. To display the outline type button, add the predefined class eOutline to the CSS class property. Look here, the button is rendered with a transparent background and a border. I can also add an icon to the button. To add a play icon, I add the icon CSS property and set the class names eButtonSBIcons and ePlayIcon. Then, within this style.css file, I define a font face rule with a specific source path and name to access the play icon at the application level. Then, assign appropriate content values to these class names assigned to the icon CSS property. As you can see, the button is displayed with the play icon. Notice that the play icon is placed to the left of the button content. To change a position, I set the icon position property to right. Checking now, the icon is placed to the right of the button content. Next, I will show you how to toggle the button state. For a better understanding, I remove the other properties except the content and set the isToggle property to true. As toggle has two states, active and inactive, there must be two contents, so I add the click event with the appropriate event handler, buttonClick. Also, include an ID named toggleButton to identify the button instance when the click event occurs. Next, navigate to the app component file and import the view child decorator. Then, import the button component from the Syncfusion Angular buttons. Using the view child decorator, I get the reference to the button element. Next, define a local variable called toggleButton of the type button component. Then, I define the event handler for the button click. When the event occurs, I will change the state of the button. If the toggle button is in an active state, change its content to pause, and vice versa. Notice here, when I click the button, its content is changed. Finally, to disable the button component, set the disabled property to true. Checking now, the button is disabled. In this video, I showed you how to create an Angular application and add the Syncfusion Angular button component. You also saw how to define button types, add and position icons, apply custom styles to the button, and disable the component. If you want to see a working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link to know if you qualify for a free license key to use our Angular products through our community license. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.